Welcome again. Today we define the term biochemical oxygen demand, BOD, and explain how this indirect method is used to assess pollution levels in water. And we describe and explain an indirect method of measuring pollution using a biotic index. Biochemical oxygen demand, BOD, is a measure of the amount of dissolved oxygen required to break down the organic material in a given volume of water through aerobic biological activity. Bacteria that consume oxygen need to decompose this organic material. As organic material is decomposed, oxygen is depleted. This loss of oxygen happens because aerobic bacteria, oxygen-consuming bacteria, in eating or feeding on this organic waste as a source of energy, they consume oxygen. And the more organic waste that they get, the more they grow and multiply and metabolize the waste, and the result is that more oxygen is consumed. It is this high amount of organic load that sucks up or demands a high volume of oxygen to be decomposed. So as the organic waste is degraded and it becomes less, the consequence of that is a fall in the amount of dissolved oxygen. More pollution introduces more organic matter. As this organic matter is degraded, it places a high demand on oxygen. As this oxygen is consumed, there is less dissolved oxygen in the system. To measure this biochemical oxygen demand, a bottle is submerged beneath the surface and allowed to fill with water. While still below the surface, the bottle is capped. Two samples are taken on day one. In one bottle, the level of dissolved oxygen is measured using probes or titrations. The other bottle is wrapped in an opaque liner and placed in an incubator at 20 degrees Celsius for 5 days. On day 5, the dissolved oxygen level in the second bottle is measured, and then the difference in dissolved oxygen levels between day 1 and day 5 is a measure of the biochemical oxygen demand. The amount of dissolved oxygen required to break down the organic material in this given volume of water through aerobic biological activity. If BOD is high, the amount of oxygen in a system is low as a result of the high organic load that has to be decomposed by bacteria. Due to differences in tolerance, only certain kinds of macroinvertebrates can thrive in this oxygen-deprived environment. The diversity and abundance of these macroinvertebrates can also be used as an indicator of water quality. In this image, we see a biologist doing a kick sampling of an aquatic system to collect these macroinvertebrates, with his boot being used to flick samples into the net. A typical protocol for kick sampling requires you to place the net downstream of your body and to kick 20 times into the net. A well-known index for studying water quality is the Trent Biotic Index. In using a biotic index, there's no need to monitor water quality directly, for the presence of certain kinds of indicator species would tell you about the levels of oxygen. Caddisfly larvae, for example, thrive in high oxygen environments, So the presence of high amounts of caddisfly larvae in your sample would be an indirect way of saying that the dissolved oxygen levels are high. The presence of dragonfly larvae suggests that dissolved oxygen levels may be in a medium type level, not very high, but also not very low. A high abundance of bloodworms or midge larvae indicates water that has a very high level of pollution, usually from sewage outfalls. So the Trent Index is a quick way of using the presence of certain easy to observe macroinvertebrates to make inferences about the levels of dissolved oxygen based on the abundance and diversity of the indicator species. Dissolved oxygen is low in this aquatic system, around 2 to 3 parts per million. What can you predict about the biochemical oxygen demand? Which of the following is most abundant in this aquatic system?